Hello friends, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. I am Frederick and this is .NET 8 Blazor for Beginner series. In this video, we are going to talk about routing and navigation in Blazor. Implementing navigation and routing in Blazor component is very important because it allows you to move from one component to another. In that, you can also specify parameters that you want to send as well. Now, in Blazor component, there are three ways of defining route or navigation in Blazor. The first one is what by defining route. We have two, by creating navigation link. And the third one here is by using or handling navigation event. In Blazor, you can perform navigation both on the client side, that's a Blazor WebAssembly, and also on the server side, that's a Blazor server. So this that we're going to have a look on, we can perform this to any of the render modes. Talking about the interactive server, interactive WebAssembly, and an interactive auto, and that is the fusion of the WebAssembly and the server. Then, how do you configure and work with routing in Blazor? In Blazor applications, routing is responsible for mapping URLs to components, allowing the navigation and the display of different pages based on the URL. Routing in Blazor can be configured and customized to suit the need of your application. So we're going to have a look on how to implement this routing on pages or components. And also, when we talk about navigation between pages and components, you can use the anchor element, or that's the anchor element or the anchor tag, to navigate from a component to another component. And the last one here is you can use the navigation manager to handle navigation events. So I have a project here, Blazor web app, and now we're going to choose this is the name, Blazor web app routing navigation. I'm going to click on next, and the render mode, I'm going to choose the server. If you want to know any of these, how to use it, check the video description and also check the playlist for beginners. I have it explained in there. Okay, we choose the server for default. Once the app created, you can just close this. Then when you go to Solution Explorer, you can see from the component folder, we have pages. We have default 3 or 4 pages in here. Now within that, 3 of these components have a default route specified. When you click on the counter, there is a way to specify the route. So the route here, it is a navigation to the page. Now you see here we have at page, then you pass in the name in here. Okay, now the route they must not be the same. When you have multiple components, you make sure you do not have 2 components or many components having the same route. This is counter, for example. Now when you go to the next component like home page, you cannot also write the same thing as counter. Here must be the different one altogether. Now with this, when you check this page here, you can see we have only this for a slash. It tells you that that is a default page. So this is a home page. When the app renders, there is a page, or this is a landing page. So if you want to set any page as a landing page, then you have to specify this in here. And maybe if you want to specify this landing page to this weather forecast, it means you can remove this one. And now when you go to the home page, you can see now we have the same route. So the home page has the same thing. So this means that you have to overwrite this and I make it as home. You see? So that you do not have the same component having the same route, else you're going to have an ambiguous exception, etc. You're going to have something like that. Okay, so that's the first thing to do. So specifying the route. So now we've switched the home page to the weather forecast, isn't it? Now let's save all this and I run and see by default we have to land on this weather forecast page. So let's run this application and see. So the app has loaded and I can see that the default page it is what? Although we have the home here, but we see we have this weather forecast page because it's set to default. Now if I click on this and now the right now we specify slash home, it means you're going to navigate us to this home page. As you can see, if I remove this, going back to the default page, that is the weather forecast. Okay, now let's see. Let's try to, this is the home page. Let's also set this as home page. And now let's run this and see the biggest exception that we are going to have. Okay, so the page is now loading, and now let's wait and see. Yeah, so you see we have an unhandled exception occurred while processing the request, isn't it? We have ambiguous match exception. Now the request matched multiple endpoints. So how many endpoints? We have two endpoints in here. And now when we check our solution, check our component, you can see that we have the home at the same endpoint, and now we have the weather forecast at the same endpoint. So that's why we have this ambiguous exception. So anytime that you want to set up a route for a component that you have created, you make sure you do not have a repeated or duplicated name as a route. You must have a different name altogether. And now from the home page, you can set any of the page as a home page by specifying only the forward slash, and that's going to be the endpoint as a default endpoint that's going to be lined on when the application runs. Okay, so now let's go back and now let's make here as weather. And now this problem is solved. Okay, so that is a way to navigate or specify the routing of components. Let's talk about the second one. We have navigation. How to use the anchor tag to also navigate. So let's say we are in the home page here. You want to have a button that if I click on this button, it should navigate to this weather forecast page. How can we do that? I believe this is very simple, and you know this already, isn't it? From the HTML basics, I believe you know it. So let's say we have this anchor tag. Now this anchor tag, you have to specify the href tag. Now this href attribute, what you need to do here is specifying the name of the component. So you can use either forward slash and I'll specify this weather. Okay, so let's say this is weather one. We can also make a duplicate of this, and now here we can remove this. Okay, so and also pass in this weather, and this is going to be weather two. So let's see which one will work. We want to reference this, the weather forecast page. So we are creating this anchor tag, and now the first one here we're passing in the forward slash, second we decide not to pass in that. Let's run this and see what's gonna happen. So the page is ready. So if I click on this, let's see, now we are in the, that's navigated to the forecast page. Let's go back to the home, and now this contains no forward slash, but you see that if I also click on that, it also works. So you see that in order to navigate, you can decide to specify the forward slash, or you can decide to escape it, and it's still going to work. Okay, so when you make a reference like this and do not specify, default is going to be added to you. It's going to be added. If it is there, then that's fine. But in case it is not, it should be added automatically. So we need not to specify this in there. But it's a choice. You can decide to make a choice to which one that you want to use in your application. So this also another way to navigate to page using this anchor tag. All right, let's talk about the last one, using the event or the navigation event. Now this is coming from an interface that we need to inject. So we're going to write inject navigation manager. So navigation manager, you need to create an instance of this. So let's say this is nav manager. So with this, what you can do here is, let's also create another button in here, and this could be a button like this. Okay, so now with this button like this, let's wire up an event to this button. So we're going to say at onClick. So this is a C# code at onClick. Then we can say go to weather page. Okay, so go to weather. The name of this button that you want to give here, it is go to weather. So go to weather page. Now with this, let's give it a little style. So we're going to have a class. We're going to use a bootstrap class. So btn primary. Okay, so as you have this, let's give a method definition to this. So you know this is a UI, and we must have a code that makes it at a razor syntax. So in here, we're going to have void. Then we paste our method. So if I click on this method, what should happen? We have this nav manager instance created. So dot, it has an endpoint known as what? Navigate to. So this navigate to, we can specify in the name or the route. So you want to go to weather. And now this also works same as this. We can decide to specify only the name, or we can decide to also add the forward slash. So choose your choice. And now this also navigate to the page. But when we run this, do you think this will work? Do you think it will work? Let's try that and see. So I think it has been rendered already. And now let's go to the home. So we have go to weather page. If I click on this, see what happened? Nothing happens. Can you tell the reason why? Because you know this is a render mode, and defaultly it is statically rendered. So it's when this page is rendered statically, it tells you that here no event is going to work. Okay? If I click on any button, this page is not interactive because it is rendered in a static mode. Now with this, to make this work, we have to make it as server side, as an interactive server, because that's what we created the project for. So at render mode, then we say interactive server. So let's save this one, and now let's check it up and see. I think it has been rendered. Oh no, so unless we do it manually, since we've added render mode to this, we have to rerun this. So now let's click on this button and check it out. So you see now it has been navigated to the page. Alright, so you see there are three ways that you can navigate to components, and that is the routing and navigation. So defaultly you can specify the route on top of each page that you want to get up to. Second, you can use the anchor element or the anchor tag to navigate from one page to another page. And the last one here is by injecting the navigation manager and also wind up an event and defining it here and navigating to the specific component that you want to. But before you pass it in here, the name of this component must be the same as the route that you specified in here. So you can say that you want to navigate to this weather one, and now here we are saying that go to weather. No, it's not going to work because this is not going to be found. The endpoint here, it is weather one. So it must specify the same thing inside this navigate to endpoint, okay, to be able to navigate to that specific component. All right, so that is it for today. I believe you've seen how to route a page and also how to navigate between pages. Try your hands on it. You can just go over this video again to get the concept. All right, so thank you so much. The next video, we're going to talk about a different thing altogether, which you're going to love it. So then, take care, and I'm going to catch you up in the next video.